So you also got to get out of the studio and go on these trips, like a spring break trip, or didn't you do some like Bon Jovi weekends?
Yes.
What was that like? What was Bon Jovi like?
Any Bon Jovi fans out there?
Yes.
I started to become more of the out of studio guy because I like doing, I felt hemmed in the studio. I just didn't like it. And frankly, I didn't really like interviewing rock stars. I mean, it wasn't that the asking questions journalism part of it wasn't something I could handle. I just got bored stiff. I mean, with Motley Crue, it's like, what do you ask and what do you expect to get as an answer from Tommy Lee? You know, it's like, you know, this new album is so, I don't know, deep. Yeah. How did what was the writing process like? Well, Alan, we really dug deep. We wanted it to be totally different from anything we'd ever done, you know, like an opera, and you didn't hear any of that. It was like, it's girls, girls, girls. It's party, party, party. So I got, unless it was a Peter Gabriel or I interviewed The Edge and Bono, who came on, and it was great to have artists like that are now huge, that came on for the first time in America on MTV. So I introduced, they came into the studio, sat down, I said, now with us, The Edge and Bono.
So many did that.
I hadn't heard his name pronounced yet, you know, and the producer's like, ooh. And he goes, and The Edge goes, Bono, for the rest of the interview, like, hey, Bono.
Don't you think he got that a lot, though, at the beginning?
I think that's Simon Le Bon, isn't it, from Duran Duran?